New South Wales Premier Mike Baird is indirectly lending great support to the Queensland Government's push for tougher lockout laws.
And said, thank you for what has happened in relation to those lockout laws. I cannot tell you the difference it's made.
But overnight, more than 10,000 people bombarded his Facebook page. Most furious, Sydney's lockout laws look to live on, despite a slated review.
But if there are things we can do to improve it, or enhance it, or we've overlooked, or there's other opportunities, well, that's what the review will consider.
Critics claim the restrictions have killed the vibrant nightlife. Australian DJ Alice in Wonderland posting, Sydney has become a nanny state and is now a laughingstock internationally.
It was those venues that were really struggling to start off with that really ended up, you know, not being able to compete.
Tom Nikolowski goes to some of that. Go ahead.
Good evening, panel. How can Sydney see itself as an international hub when the shops close at 5:30, food can't be served past midnight, and lockout laws mean that you can't get a drink past 1:30? Do we not see that nanny state laws are to the detriment of Australia and the fun that can be had here?
Gordon.
Too easy. First of all...
Clearly things have got to be looked at. I mean, 3 a.m. is a different to 12 a.m. Yeah. But in terms of how pub rock and the way people need to go to gigs, I think it's more the pokey machines, frankly.
Yeah.
I think, you know, the pubs where people used to play and go and talk to each other, well, you know, and I, you know, look, this is a broad subject, but culturally, Australia has always punched very, very much above its weight internationally with its music industry, and that absolutely starts live. That starts on the streets, it starts in the pubs, and we need to address that, but that's a different...
With the lockout laws?
Yeah, it's not just about a few venues closing, not being able to party after 1:33. It's about the decimation of Sydney's culture, and if the government wants to take it off us, I'm sorry, but we protest.